The killer instinct. I don't know. This might not be the Reaper quest. I don't know. Doesn't quite sound like it. Plus, Lieutenant, you there, you're the fighting sword, yes? And by the looks of it, one of no mean skill. There's now a plane going over my house. You're gonna be able to hear planes and cars a lot more, because I have my window open. I'm sorry, but it's too toasty in here. My employer is in desperate need of a man of your talents. Don't assume. You see, he's been beset by threats from an unsavory group of thugs known as the Lemures. Their leader demands my master part with some of his considerable wealth, or, well, I'll just tell you, they call her the Reaper and leave the rest to your imagination. We don't intend to acquiesce to these churlish demands without a fight, and a stout arm by our side would go far to ensure our survival. Your arm, perhaps? In case, oh my god. Hello? Hang on, I don't speak English. In case the opportunity to perform a good deed isn't enticement enough, please be reminded that my master possesses considerable wealth. If you would aid us, come with Ace to the Sapphire Avenue Exchange, where we would make our stand against these brutes. Yo, look at the bunnies here, dude. Wait, that's not a bun. That's not a bun, no. This is a bun, though. Bun. Bun! Yo, squad! Cue time, oh no. Did you update text tools correctly? Like, update it and then hit start over and re-add the mod pack? You! I know why you're here, and if you mean to lay a finger on my coin purse, you'll have to pry it from my cold, lifeless... Master... Gigilio? Master Gigilio, he's a friend. This adventurer has agreed to help. We'll show the Reaper what her empty intimidations are worth. Oh, I see. My apologies, sir. Tensions have been high as of late, as I'm sure you can understand. For reasons that elude me, these Lemures have made my life a waking nightmare. Sight unseen, they have demanded I begin paying them for the luxury of my own life. Rumors abound of their origins. Some say they are the... Detritus? I don't know that word. Some say they are the detritus of some barbaric nation. They flaunt our laws and threaten their betters with impunity. They're led by a dead-eyed killer who draws her scythe at the smallest slight. Refuse their payments of coin, and she takes the share. Oh, I got french fries today. They're led by a dead-eyed killer who draws her scythe at the smallest slight. Refuse their payments of coin, and she takes her share of your lifeblood instead. Rubbish, I say. The Reaper is naught but a toothless bandit. She's gonna show up around the corner, and he's gonna scream like a baby. Interesting theory you have there. Care to test it? Yeah, no, he's gonna- ah! That's the necklace I always use!
Van Damme Jeff 2 gifted a tier 1 sub to Cola Nero. They have given 295 gift subs in the channel.
Thank you, Van, for gifting another sub. Thank you. Oh god, wait, are you done with work? I have to hurry up and unlock Reaper. You're the Reaper! Dude, I use that chest piece for my aiming glamour, and I use that necklace. Oh wait, she's kinda old. Oh, you're a perceptive one, ain't? Okay, well. Ain't you? She said like something with an N apostrophe and now... Give him. Oh, you're a perceptive one, ain't you? Suppose that's how you came to be in possession of so many shiny things. I guess that also makes sense since they're supposed to be, botanists or farmers, you know, originally. And what do we have here? Hire more help while our ledgers remain unbalanced? You wouldn't be trying to wriggle your way out of paying us for a job well done, would you? You've hired these lemurs before? Mama, how do you keep the last straight? You didn't tell your hired muscle here what great friends we were? So great, in fact, that you trusted none other than me and mine to put the scare into your competition. A job we were happy to do. You can't find your fortune in this fair city without stepping over a few bodies on the way, after all. But as flexible as our morals are, I'm afraid without the coin to bend them, we only have one recourse. Unless... She's dying me up. I'd be out of my character too. One does wonder how you found yourself with a bodyguard of such uncommon metal. I had not an ounce of fear in that gaze, and not a mote of puffed up arrogance either. This lad, my dear Gigilio, is the genuine article. She's literally caca at my character! They have what we in the mercenary trade call the killer instinct. Yeah, that gaze literally blindfolded. Amira, how's this? For the sake of our long-standing friendship, I'll make it simple. Allow me to take this adventure off your hands, and the debt is forgiven. What? That's all? I believe this is what them in your trade call a bargain. As for you, adventurer, it seems you've been made a free agent. But if you're still inclined to put those instincts of yours to use, come visit our headquarters in Pearl Lane. The door's open. Okay, that's... very interesting. Boss told me you'd be long coming in. You sure? What? Boss, the guest of honor's arrived. Boss.
What the dog doing?
What the dog doing? Doodly doo! Doodly doo! Ah, the savior of Al. Wait. No. Southern accent. Ah, the savior of Alamigo and Doma Danes to appear before me. I have heard all about you. It's hard not to in this line of work. Stories paint you as ferocity incarnate, a force of nature few have survived. Man, thank you!
Vandama Jeff 2 gifted a tier 1 sub to Teppo Man.
Star!
They have given 296 gift subs in the channel.
Peace, friend. I've no desire to put the killer to the proof personally. I don't have a death wish. Aw. You can call me Drusilla. I'm a Reaper, one of many, and the leader of this little family here. As to why I invited you into our home, there's a job I'd like you to take care of for me. I won't work with criminals and thieves!
What's the job?
Now don't you worry that virtuous heart of yours, eh? I wouldn't ask you to do so much as bend the law. This job is purely for the benefit of your fellow man. All you have to do is kill one for me. Though perhaps kill ain't the right word, seeing as he's already dead. Am I exercising a spirit? Don't look so surprised. I know you've seen the dead walk. This time you'd be up against a void scent, come here to unleash its singular brand of wickedness upon the world. It won't be an easy task. The evil driving this monster is black as the void and near as deep. Countless souls have succumbed to its hunger. Worthy prey for one inclined to heroics, don't you think? You can't face it as you are, though, store it as your strength may be. I'll need to train you in techniques. Techniques that'll let you pierce the void and slaughter its kin.
Keep talking.
He's but sure. Yeah, Adam doesn't play Final Fantasy. Oh, don't see many Garleans in old doll, do you? Let alone ones as savage as this. Save your startled gasps. I'm not out of surprises yet. Gimme. Hold your hand out to the crystal here. If you're made of the stuff I think you are, then you're in for a treat. Gimme. That's it. I knew you had what it takes. Give me. This would be an avatar, a manifestation of your essence and the Stygian power of the Void Sent on the other side. A Void Sent to which, if you so choose, you will bind to yourself. Yeah. You'll gain skills unlike anything you've ever known. Skills that have allowed people like me to operate in the shadows and kill those that need killing since time immemorial. And your first assignment, should you walk its path, is to use the power of one Void Sent against another for the betterment of the realm. Your reward will be the wisdom of countless generations of Garlean assassins.
Oh.
But if siding with my kind makes your stomach turn, then I need to read it! At the thought of having one foot in the void makes your stone shrivel. This is too fast! I can't read it! And if you've any concern for the sanctity of your soul, then take your virtue and piss off. No, I didn't get to read it! Thank you, Inka, for the raid! However, if you've none of the aforementioned objections and you don't mind walking the knife's edge twixt life and death, then you'll have the tools to see your justice done, and done right, every time. Dude, that was so fast! I feel like I can normally read pretty quickly, but that was so fast. This is the choice you must make, and soon. Every moment our quarry stalks the land is another opportunity for it to do harm. I'm already late. I'm supposed to be reading at a first grade level. Okay, Adam, what did it say? Tell me, type it out right now. Tell me what it said right now. You have 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7. Shit, the music in here. There'll be no turning away once you've chosen, mind you. You'll dance with death and return as its envoy, or you won't return at all. So what'll it be? Not suffer the swines of the innocent, I will dance. I just have bees sneezing. I will dance. Oh yeah, I won't have the Reaper icon. That's true. Yeah, the Reaper one, for me, I think the Reaper one is a chocobo. Oh, let me check. We'll see right now. New quest complete music? I love that sound whenever you unlock stuff. Okay, I'm pogging. Oh wait, she gives you a deep cold scythe. Oh. Awkward. No one look! No, stop! Stop! Don't look! Naked. Okay. I'm covered. Literally Kaka. Literally, Kaka. Yeah, thank you. How do you find the way to the scythe in your hands? Please and I hope. Now that we have a bit more in common, it's time we became better acquainted. What's the name of our newest Reaper?
Your mom!
Doesn't quite roll off the tongue, but so it is with Eorzean names. With every new one I learn, one more is forgotten. Yours can replace Jigilio. After our little conversation, I think he'll give us a wide berth. Any road, we've more worthwhile concerns than shifty merchants. Namely, getting you converse well and proper in the tricks of our trade. And the best way to do that is through battle. One of the family is having trouble with a particularly vexing fiend and has sent word asking for assistance. He goes by the name of Arnagus, and he's stationed out near Cutter's Cry. Not much of a fighter, but he's got a keen mind for trading and find a needle in a stack of needles if need be. We best hurry before he ends up at the bottom of some monster's gullet. Yo, this guy's fashion. Hey boss, who's this? Are you sure we should be getting an outside involved? Thank you for your discretion, Arnagis, but that ain't needed. He has a personal contract with me, so consider him a mercenary in service to the family. Whatever you'd say in front of me, you can say in front of him. By your will, boss. Chimera has been making these sands a living hell for anyone who cares to wander into its territory, which should be us, since our trade route cuts right through it. Yeah, Reaper uses maiming gear, yeah. Thanks for the reminder, yeah. Thank you, Van, for gifting 5 subs for the rescues. If it's Vande a sub for every rescue,
just gifted 5 subs.
I think you owe more. The men I've hired to carry my goods are scared to death, and I can't blame them. None of us are fit for monster hunting, so I sent for you. We'll see what we can do, Arnagis. Might want to find a rock to hide behind, though. Chimeras ain't known for being the most discriminating of beasts. Only 5 today, okay. And bye, you're leaving! That's it, you rescue me to death and then you leave? Time to put your new skills to good use. You have learned all Reaper actions and traits to level 70. Yeah, just level 70. What do you have? Easy peasy, dude. Bloody impressive work, bet. I knew there was something about you, but truth be told, I didn't expect you to make such clean work of that chimera. I reckon even I might be hard-pressed to match that display. See, she says, like, I reckon, stuff like that. Yeah, this guy, he had a New York accent. You know Thalen when you see it, boss. And with that, the Cerulean will flow once more. See? New York. Or Joyzy, one of those, I don't know. Among his many roles, Arnagis is a merchant of sorts. He sells Cerulean at a price that'll make those gill pinchers that Amagina and Sons balk, but still turns a pretty profit. We can barely keep up with the man, despite the occasional beast or two button into our affairs. Should probably turn down the music a little bit. All thanks to you, boss, and our countrymen up north, of course. He's to getting back to business as usual. It's really been easy to come by, as you well know. Amagina and Sons protects their monopoly with a gilded fist, but they've yet to force the Imperial stragglers up north out of the market. Now, before you go running off to the flames, let me assure you that this arrangement is entirely above board. Selling goods to Imperials is forbidden by law, but there's an area word writ about buying from them. I know you Eorzeans like to call Garleans by all sorts of colorful names. Bastards, tyrants, invaders, and we've got all those and worse. But while many a foul deed has been committed for the glory of the Empire, we ain't megalomaniacs to a man. Even amongst the purebloods, those that serve don't always do so by choice. Could be argued we're all casualties of the Great Machina's ambition. No small number of the Empire's troops would return home in a heartbeat if they could, but the world being what it is, most settle for sending their family a few coins they can afford to part with. Most Eorzeans wouldn't suffer a whit of color to complicate their black and white view, but if you're going to fight with us, you should learn the truth of our past. Long ago, long before the Empire, our forebears lived in Locus Ammonis, down in southern Ilseberd. With temperate climates and fertile earth, the land provided. Most of us were but simple farmers, harvesting abundant crops of the self-same size the reapers would eventually wield. But gifts are ever the object of envy. While not tilling the fields, our ancestors were forced to defend them. Every year, they yielded a few more elms, and some 800 years ago now, they were driven from Locus Ammonis completely. They fled north, the frozen region that would become Garlemald. Even there, they fought tooth and nail for the scant resources of that frigid land. From the fires of hardship were the first magitech devices forged, and with innovation upon innovation, that humble group of farmers grew into an insatiable empire. But before that miraculous twist of fate, we were a dying breed, bereft not only of magic, but of hope itself. With no natural advantages to speak of, our mere survival was in question. Thank you. From harsh necessity were the Reapers born. We turned our tools to weapons and struck a bargain with the Whispers in the dark. With the Void's power, we could strike at an army's beaten heart, slay their generals, and throw the rank and file into disarray. Our way is to end battles before the sparks catch, to sacrifice the one for the many, to keep avaricious hands away from family, friends, and lovers. And now this power belongs to you. I want instrumental. Remember our story. Remember what drives a man to turn to the Void, and you'll not be led under deeper temptations. Our work here is done. I'll see you back at headquarters. For your first outing, you did good. I think you've earned the right to know just who this lot you've thrown yourself in with is. Holy fuck, that sentence fucked me up. You might have gathered this yourself, but the Lemurians were formed to support those Garleans who were living in exile. Tain't easy? What the fuck? It ain't easy to be far from home, let alone in a place where most would sooner gut you than offer a helping hand. Oft the only place to make a living is in the shadowy corners that lie outside the watchful gaze of the law. Now, I don't expect you to embrace us like brothers and sisters straight away, but know this, I do expect you to apply yourself to this job. Hey, you got it. In the meantime, I'll be working with the family to ascertain the whereabouts of our prey. I expect that sap to be like an extension of your own body when next we speak. Hey, it already is, homie. Stop. There you are, looking deadly enough with that sap to make me weak at the knees. Same. I wager it's time we stop faffing about and make ready to hunt our target. My Lemurians have been hard at work scraping together what information they can. Let's see what they've got. Dude, I just want to AFK in this room because of the music. Everyone here? Good. Aren't a guest you've met. No further chimera-related incidents you'll be happy to hear. I struggled to read that. The overly chipper lass over there is Hartman. Make your acquaintances. Overly chipper lass. Who is the crippler you're hearing? She's not saying that. As you know, our quarry is a void sand. He goes by the name Orcus. He's eluded the best, but these two are a step above that. Tell us what you found. Okay, what voice do we give her? She said she described her as overly chipper. Lisp? Okay. Lisp and excited, I guess. By your will, bot, I asked the roundabout unsolved murder, then disappearance, the thing, if any, involved someone matching the description you provided. There's as many missing people as there are grains of sand, and no shortage of tragedies either. One, however, stood out among the rest. A woodcutter in the black shroud disappeared without a trace. No body, no belongings, nothing. An odd enough occurrence by itself, but the sightings of a stranger with skin pale as snow near his last known location, whereabouts, piqued our interest. Now that's a promising start, but those woods are crawling with bandits and brigands of all sort. Duskwats and keepers are said to come in ghostly hues. Are we sure this man ain't one of them? As sure as I've ever been, boss. Not many bandits have eyes the color of blood. It's a match too close to ignore. Can't gainsay that. We have a lead. If I may, Both, are you Thor? We need the help of this outsider. How much trouble could one void them be? Hartman, he's standing right there, for God's sake! No, she's right. I've always told you to turn a wary eye to those outside the family. Oh my God. She's just doing her due diligence. But trust me when I say we need every advantage we can afford. I made the mistake of misjudging Orcus's strength before, and for my hubris, my family, my flesh and blood family, was slain. All of them. I was planning on holding that back a bit longer, but t'was before the Lemurs. I swore two things. I'd repay that suffering 1,000-fold, and I'd never let that bastard take anything from me again. I mean to keep my vow, and I trust I can count on you to help. Don't have to ask twice, Both. Your wounds are our wounds, even the ones that became Garth. We'll see your vengeance rot. All these years I scraped to make a place for us. I look forward to the day he'd pay his dues. And it ain't just for me that we have to hunt him down either. He's a blight on Eorzea itself, and the longer we let it fester, the more suffering it'll spread. We need to corner him now while we have the chance. You ready, Clarissa? You know those woods as well as any of us, and we'll need your experience if we hope to be back before supper. What? Much appreciated. Alright, let's get to it then. Herman, I want you here in Uldah, keeping your ear to the ground for any news of Orcus's movements. Arnigus, you lead us to where this woodcutter disappeared. 1/10 of a second slower. By your will, boss. That'd be the central shroud, so our best course would be to set off from the Bent Branch Meadows. Good, you made it. Before we set off, allow me to share the circumstances of our poor woodcutter's disappearance. As I heard it, he disappeared nigh on a week ago, got lost, some surmise, but he was a seasoned woodsman, not some highborn traveler who forgot to buy a mitt. I questioned those closest to him, and none could think of a reason that he might want to make himself scarce. We'd even made plans to meet with his friends not long from now, but I expect that promise will go unkept. Women can't age, yeah, totally. Maybe it'll be creepy too, so I'm safe. Yeah, you weren't like, she's fucking ugly. You're safe for now. For now. Sounds like we can rule out a voluntary departure. I believe we can. The last person to see a man alive said he took his axe and ventured northwest. And that's where we'll set our trap. Here, take these. A Magitek transceiver and candle that sounded like a Vortent's favorite libation. Blood. Okay. Ball. Once it's lit and the fumes are wafting through the air, every void sent within 30 yams will come running. If either of us sees Orcus, let's give the other a shout over the transceiver. As I said before, Orcus is inhabited in the body of a man, and he can put on an awfully convincing performance when needs must. Don't give him a chance to work his wiles, or his fangs will be in your neck before you know it. As much as I want to accompany you, I'd only be a liability in a fight. Whether you find Orcus or not, return here and I'll report back to the Lemures. Good luck and good hunting. Good luck and good hunting. I switched to a southern accent for the last sentence. Drawn by the maleficent odor, a void scent rises from the underbrush. Though it bears no resemblance to Orcus, it eyes you with a voracious hunger. Ooh. I'm glad to see you in one piece. Now, what's that you have in your hand? Blood-soaked ring. The ring is colored red blood, although with whose is uncertain. Ominous. You said the void scent was carrying this. That ring. Where'd you find it? Rubber, 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 rubber. I see. And there can be no doubt. The void scent that Clarissa slew is the very same one that murdered our woodcutter. Moited. Are you saying... Ah, while I was searching for a place to set my trap, I spotted a shallow grave, hastily dug and poorly hidden. Under a thin layer of dirt was a body matching the description of the woodcutter, a wholly nondescript fellow save for the mark of a ring removed from his finger. Doubtless that ring was his demise. Shiny baubles are a common fixation for void scent. Probably didn't spare a thought for the owner, only the prize. I suppose we can take comfort in the knowledge that it'll harm no one else. Well, guess or none, I'd say this expedition was a success after a fashion. I should apprise the whalers of what's transpired. You two catch some well-earned rest. Yeah, totally, we're gonna rest. Yeah, for sure. Well, you're back in queue again? What, you got kicked out of queue? Maybe we didn't get the satisfaction I promised, but sitting here with our heads in our hands won't do us any good. Let's be happy with one less void scent preying on helpless woodcutters. Orcus will pay for what he did. Glad to see a passion for our mission. Apologies we couldn't make your first outing more memorable. We were on the cusp of ending 2 decades of misery. That's how long ago Orcus came into this world, raging like an animal free from his cage and leaving my family dead in his wake. The grief he's caused since then is immeasurable. No matter where he is, a curse of feet take him, his hunger follows, and the realm bleeds to sate it. Of course, we aren't the only ones hunting him, but he's as clever as he is vicious, and not even the finest trackers have been able to keep on his trail for long. Don't lose heart yet, Both. While you were away, I was making the rounds, and I might have found something that'll soon bear fruit. Arnageth is following up on it as we speak. I swear, someday that man is gonna keel over on my account. Still, there's no one else I trust to tell me the difference between truth and hysteria. That being said, his work takes time to do right. Use this chance to hone your skills, and if all goes to plan, next time we speak, you'll have a golden opportunity to test him. I'm guessing that taking care of that guy is going to be the final quest. Apologies, Clarissa, but we're still waiting on Arnegus to come through. There's not much for you to do around here until then, unless you have a knack for cleaning. Carmen is good at wheedling out promising doors and whatnot, but again, to the truth of those stories is a craft as delicate as weaving. I'm sure you come firsthand how bad one bit of information can lead to elaborate plans coming apart at the seams. Yeah, I don't know how long the timer is, but yeah, it does tell you. Oh wait, this is a new guy. Boss! Calm down, lad. Breathe. What's gotten into you? It's Arnegus. He's been murdered. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. What? Tell me I heard that wrong. I'm afraid not. The brass blades found him half buried in the sands not bells ago. Just lying there like some bloody animal carcass. They're bringing him to Aerolag's burial chamber as we speak. It's not what I was expecting. That's why I gave him kind of a funny voice, and now I feel kind of bad for giving him kind of a funny voice, because it's kind of serious. Yeah, I was really not fucking expecting that, though. Literally just introduced this character. Whoever did this doesn't know the reckoning they've got coming. Before I'm done with them, they'll be begging to crawl back into their mother's womb. I want justice as much as you, Herman, I do. But it's times like these that we need to look to the boss for guidance. As you can see, Clarissa, emotions are running high. I should stay here until Herman cools off. Can you let the boss know that we're standing by and waiting for her command? Like as she's not gone up to pay her respects. Pop off, queen? Sorry, Clarissa. I ain't in the mood for chit-chat. Oh. Where's the bloody caper?
My lady, prithee, the dead must be let to rest.
The dead are gonna have one more among them if you don't shut your trap and listen. The brass blades brought in a body not too long ago. Show me to it.
Yes, that they did. But are you the deceased family? If not, I'm afraid we cannot.
Family? Family? Arnegus was like a son to me.
Like a son? Ordinarily that would be... He's interred in the innermost coffin. However, I must advise you not to gaze upon the body. She insists, and so be it.
God damn it, Arnegus. I told you not to go and get yourself.
Don't, Clarissa. This isn't for you.
I'm sorry for barging in here and for all the bluster. You can forgive my rudeness. Promise me that Arnegus gets sent off well and proper.
Of course he shall be. However, if you wish to inter him within the city gates, well, such sought-after space comes at no small expense. I don't care what it costs. Just send your man to the Lemire's headquarters to collect what you require.
Clarissa, I appreciate you coming to find me. There's someone else I have to speak with first. I'm heading to Stone's Throw. Come along if you please, but come along in silence. This is where Arnegus' dear wyverns are living. Let's get this over with. This is where she... was married.
I guess, never forgot the debt he owed you. The debt we both owed you. Even so, his loyalty ran even deeper than that. It's a strange thing to look back on the people we were. A decade younger and a lifetime more foolish. Young lovers, proud patriots, blissfully ignorant, returning to Locus Amonis, the cradle of our people. Triumphant homecoming for the Garleans after centuries in exile. The once mighty invaders had been laid low and driven back once they came, and it was a banner day when Arnagus was honored with a post there. The honor and pride quickly faded when we saw the truth of Locus Amonis. We hadn't just defeated our enemies, we had clapped them in irons and condemned them to a life of servitude. Descendants of those who'd driven our ancestors north so many generations ago, made to pay for the crimes of their forebears. The superiors were certainly pleased with the poetry of it all. Arnagus, however, cannot simply look away from their suffering, let alone take pleasure in it. Confronted with the reality of the place we could call home, his conscience demanded he take action. He began cooperating with the resistance, but the eyes of the Firmitarium were all-seeing, and before long, he was ousted as a sympathizer. It was only by the grace of good fortune that we escaped with our lives. I've often lain awake at night, wondering if he had outlived his usefulness to the resistance. Perhaps it was a petty senior officer that orchestrated the fall. Regardless of the cause, the outcome was the same. We could never return to the Empire. We fled to Eorzea by way of Razatan, the only route open to us. It wasn't soon after stepping foot on the docks of Limsa Lominsa that your luck ran out, as I recall, stopped by yellow jackets and accused of being Imperial spies. Aye, but we still managed to make an escape. We ran and ran, terrified that our pursuers would one day catch up to us. That is, until we met you. Had you not taken us under your wing when you did, I shudder to imagine our fate. Your gratitude's the last thing I deserve, Lass. If I hadn't sent Arnagus off on my damn fool's errand, he'd still be alive. It was Orcus that killed him, and no mistake. He died for my vengeance. I can't tell you how sorry I am. No, you needn't apologize. I know he was happy. So long as he was helping you, he was happy. The blame for his death doesn't rest on your shoulders. It rests on the man, the monster that murdered him in cold blood, and I expect you to see he answers for his crime. For me and for Arnagus. I will, Lass. I will. On this, I swear everything that I have to swear. We need to talk, Clarissa. Somewhere with fewer prying eyes. Come meet me at the bridge to the north. This all got really sad, really fast. Yeah.
But we damn it!
Sorry. I owe you an apology. Not telling you everything about me and Orcus from the start. I dragged you into a fight against a foe that's cunning, brutal, and utterly merciless. I thought with all of us together, we'd tip the scales in our favor. But I was wrong, and Arnagus paid the price for my hubris. That void sand we tracked in the Black Shard was likely one of Orcus's minions, but I was too caught up in my grand scheme to realize it at the time. I should have thought about why it tried to hide that body. Your common void scent wouldn't have had the guile to bury a kill. But what if Orcus taught it that as a way to throw trackers off its scent, and to dangle bait from me and mine? Orcus has used that same trick in the past, and he knows that we know it too. By dispatching his minion, we drew his attention. Arnagus was a warning. Orcus doesn't give his prey swift deaths. He toys with them, cuts into them, and savors the screams. That's how I knew he was responsible. It's like a signature, the way he leaves the bodies when he's had his fill. I only pray Arnagus doesn't take that suffering with him to the next life. Orcus will be coming for you or me next. Not right away, though. That'd be giving up the game. He wants us to keep looking over our shoulders, sleeping with one eye open. He'll wear us down without even lifting a finger. And when he finally strikes, we'll be dead on our feet. Playthings for him to do with as he pleases. That won't do. We need to bring the fight to him. No more waiting around for a lead to come to us. Won't be easy, but can I still count on your help?
I've come this far, might as well. No, for Arnagus, too.
Thank you. And if you've got no qualm risking life and limb to fight for Arnagus, to fight for me, then I've got no qualm calling you a member of my family.
Family. Curious word, that.
So cool.
Bloody, it's him, Clarissa. Orcus. Some persistent rats were nibbling at my tail. I should have known by the stench it was you and yours, Drusilla. Or should I call you... granddaughter? Shut your mouth, you thrash-damn monster! Monster? Is that any way to greet a beloved elder? Children these days. Seems one death wasn't punishment enough for you. A second should suffice for the scant remainder of your being. We're ending this here and now. Follow my lead. I thought we might save our reunion for a while longer, but if you insist, I shall feast upon your beating heart here and now. Not but dregs left in that desiccated vessel of yours. Too long has the hide been left in the sun. But your family has been replenished with fresh blood, I see. My, my, and what a bounty soul this one has. He's literally Kaka at my character right now. Your scythe may be dull, but your eye is as sharp as ever. Blinding as the sun, pure as the snow. Delectable as a boar slathered in grease. Ow! I thought to make a quick meal of you, but perhaps just this once, forbearance is in order. Such a singular specimen must be given time to fatten, to fulfill its succulent potential. It'd be a travesty to consume you ere you achieve perfection. Okay, Hisoka. When your soul is ripe with fear, swollen with hatred, and fit to burst with despair, I shall return for you, and I shall gorge. Until that time, sup well, my growing whelp. Yo, why was that such a bop, though? Imagine being a Reaper and not dashing over to talk to her. Fucking unbelievable. It's skipping the- Curse these old bones. He was right in front of me. I could have ended it with one swing. For a moment, just one moment, I saw it all again. My family slaughtered, lying at his feet. My life slipping away. And that was enough. Doubtless you have more than a few questions. I'll answer them, I promise. But now's not the time. Trust me, standing around kicking the sand won't change what's done. Let's return to headquarters and let the wind cool our heads. Then we can consider our next course of action. Yeah, fucking skipping the dialogue of what- imagine doing that quest and having no idea what just happened. Imagine skipping that. Imagine skipping that, dude. Fucking imagine! No! I'm not okay. A lot just happened. I'm not okay.
It was my own fault. If I hadn't stood there slack-jawed, if I wasn't so damn slow, we'd be rid of that abomination once and for all. What you saw used to be my grandfather, before Orcus took over. He looks green enough to be my own grandchild now. Trick of the Void, like as not. It's no secret that if a Void Zen doesn't want to devour you, probably wants to take possession of your flesh, but Orcus has a particular talent for it. And as you doubtless surmised, he's got an insatiable craving for ether. Killing is only a prelude to the act of gulping down our essence, like a drought of ale after a day's work. He's old, I can't say exactly how old, and he's acquired a taste for the finer things. Seems your soul counts among the finest he's ever seen. Things just keep getting better for us, don't they?
Wouldn't be the first time someone set their sights on my soul.
That's so. Used to being a prize pig, are we? Any road, it's clear that safety is no longer something we can take for granted. Not even in a crowded street. Not even in the middle of the day. Keep your eyes peeled. Watch out for those terrible red eyes. We're sitting chocobos for the moment. But I'll think of something and send for you as soon as I can. Until then, never sleep far from your side.